doom-mongering monks, a dozen or so people got drunk and took to the streets. They were chasing after women, yelling that we should have some fun before the storm kills us all. What should we do with them? Send them home. Oh, shit. Let's see where we're at the moment. What are we researching? Automatic prototyping? Ah! Sweet. That's the fifth tier. So we can get generator power upgrade and other stuff. Okay. We're doing decent on our food. We're really stocking up. Hello, hello! Welcome to Frostpunk. Frostpunk is one of my favorite strategy games. Let's see, we're preparing for the big storm. Now we're trying to stockpile a bunch of food, as well as hopefully try and rescue some more survivors. Yeah, the storm is gonna be coming. It's gonna be coming in just over 4 days, and I am scared! I'm scared! Negative law that we've really put in place is soup, but that's just to make sure that we survive the storm, because we've only maybe got like half the amount of food that we need, not even. So I'm a little nervous on that. We're cool as well. I'm thinking we're gonna need to build another resource depot for some coal. Where do I put it, though? That's the real question. It's always a pain trying to figure that out. Right here. Automatons for the win, because I've got automatons in, like, all my coal mines. And work in one of the steam mills and the wall drill. So we got pretty much all that automated. Soon? For crying out loud, I want to stockpile some of this coal. Let's see, it looks like we're also getting a ton of raw food in each day. That's going to be converted into 5 rations, but then also a lot of it's getting eaten up too. Let's actually slow down time real quick. Boost our coal holding. We also need to boost how much food we can hold on to. Because at the moment, our storage isn't gonna be enough. Looks like we're making about maybe 1,000 a day? Maybe? let's see. We're almost done researching tier 5 technologies, which is awesome. Because we need that. Because we need to get generator upgrade 3. Hopefully we won't have to use it, but I would want to be able to. Ah, I need 80 steel. Son of a... House insulation. Ooh. Ah, we also need that. Ah, crap. Ah, that's tough. We need a lot of steel. Like, a lot. Would it hurt if I were to move one of these guys off and throw him onto a steel mill? How bad would that be? I mean, it's not too bad. Let's see. We need to try and get 80 steel real quick. Oh, here we go. Food rations. Damn, we need another one of those built. That's burning through our steel. Ugh. Sucks. It's all good though. 10 of our people died? Wait, what? What? On expeditions? Huh? I'm confused. How? What? I have no idea what happened. That looks weird. It sucks. But that there was literally nothing we could do on that one. Come on. Really? Alright. We need to probably throw on like an emergency shift or something. Let's do that. These guys, I'm pretty sure all have extended shifts. Yeah. Would it be worth it to throw on an emergency shift? Yeah, let's throw on two of them. We need it. Ah, I hate having to. But we need it. Oh, more food rations. I think that means we probably have, what, like 2,600 or something? Okay, we're making a ton of steel. We should need bad. Looks like we're about to get more raw food. Again, storage base. Ah, what? I can't place it there? Oh, wait, it'll destroy a resource. Oh, it'll just destroy the wood. I don't care. What? Ah, oh, it's still invalid. But I can place it right here. Tough. You know what? I'll just throw it up here. Screw it. It's gonna get real sweaty. Ah! Temperature's gonna drop in a while. That sucks. If only it would just hit all at once instead. These guys with the research that we needed, especially the insulation on houses. Make sure that pretty much every house is heated. Or at least has access to one of these heaters. When we get the chance, we're going to want to upgrade them. See, food rations and new technology. Ah, crap, we need 4 more steel. Almost there. Okay, one more, and boom. Okay, tech tree. Generator power upgrade. Yes. Ah! No. If I throw on another emergency shift, it's probably gonna raise the discontent way too high. And I can't activate either of those. Okay, cool. They reached the survivors.
I want to say leave them to their fate, because I need to go get the other survivors, but at the same time, I don't... I've always escorted them. These people are on their last legs, despite taking shelter in ice crevice. Many of them suffer frostbite, hypothermia, which helps them still react to the danger of the city. They can stand on their own. Some can hardly speak.
Fuck! That's tough. Because I don't have another party to send out, and I don't know if I have enough time. To bring them all back and stuff. Bring them to our city? It'll take 13 hours, so I figure it'll probably take like 15 back. That's well over a day right there. And then back, that's maybe, what, 2 days? Oh, that's cutting it so close. Alright. One of the other ones we're probably gonna have to just send back on their own. Those ones seem pretty bad off, so hopefully one of the other ones is a lot better off. About is heating, is making sure that we don't blow through all our coal and stuff. Okay, it looks like our hunters are coming back. So that's gonna spike up our food. In the previous streams, but this game just looks fantastic. I love it. Just the little details here and there. All the smoke effects, the freezing effects, especially like on the edge of the screen. That part's my favorite. Is like when it gets colder, the edge of the screen start to freeze more and more as the ice creeps in. But when it heats up, it thaws. And we're about to get generator power upgrade 3. Max out the generator. Wait, do I have it? We did what we could to raise the heat output of the generator. This alone might not be enough. All our homes and workplaces should be as warm as possible. Yes. Huh? What just happened? Prayers at work. Sir, the people employed at this workshop refuse to work today. They intend to spend the entire shift praying. We've been working like madmen, sir. But there's only so much we can do to prepare. Let's face it, this is the end of the world. Through prayer, we can find the hope of deliverance, whatever happens. Ah! It's one of our workshops. We've got a ton of them. We'll find one of them. Out for the day. Alright. We need to upgrade. Probably somewhere along the lines of, like, heating and crap. We're not using hot houses at the moment. We don't need to worry about food intake. I don't know if we need to worry about medical. We'll think about that in a minute. We're good on housing. Let's see. Let's think about heat in a minute. We're good on resources. automatons. Automaton inventory. This will boost the efficiency of our automatons big time. But do we need it? I don't know, that's a tough one. Think about that. Let's see. Heater efficiencies. That's not bad. Let's see. Because that would bring them down to the same level of cold consumption as base heaters. It's not too bad. Steam hub efficiency would be nice. How much do they burn? 3? That might be worth it, honestly. I'm trying to go for the steam hub efficiency. Let's see if there's any other alternatives, because I can't really think of any. Honestly, yeah. Let's go for that. And we will get us some... We'll save us some coal before the storm hits. Plus, I should research pretty quickly. Since it's a pretty minor one, too. We're probably going to need another resource depot for food. And I'm probably going to want another one. Oh, wait, no, that's a gathering post. My bad. Another one as well for some more coal. Yeah. That works. Stockpile a good amount of that just to play it safe. I think it might also be even worth it to build another automaton. Probably, yeah. Why not? I don't know if it would help much, but... Eh. I think we'll be alright. Sweet, okay. Range upgrade, and now to boost their efficiency. So they use 33% less coal. That means that instead of the base 3, they'll use 1. I mean, no, they'll use 2. I'm dumb. And hey, every little bit helps. Every little bit will help. Are food supplies ready? Yes! Is... Oh, these are all set to the range 2 level. Oh. Also... Oh, okay. We're fine on that. Let's see. Another one right there. There's one right here. Let's flip these over to the number 1 setting. When it comes to range. Oh, I didn't need to close out of that. I'm dumb. We don't need to be burning that much at the moment. Oh wait, no, I didn't want to turn that off. If I can click on it. No! Stop it. There we go. Set those all ones. Because also, I pretty much have it set up already for the range of that. Oh wait, why don't I just rotate? At a special moment. I think I got them all. Yeah, I only had a few anyways. So. Do that. Yeah. All of our food gathering stuff doesn't really need heating at all. Same with, like, mining and steel. since we got automatons on that. Okay, more food. Looks like our scouting party is almost back with those survivors. Let's see, each one of the child shelters has 15 kids, so 6 in total. 1, 2, 3, 4. Enough for 60 kids, and at what? Yeah, like 90. Maybe they'll 2 more? Dang it. Here and right here? Yeah, that probably perfect. Yeah. Nice. Okay, I've got enough room for all my children. Palliative care. Let's boost our. Snap. How fast patients are healed. It'll take us a little bit of food, but with how much we've got and how much we're raking in, honestly, I'm gonna get all these people healed up real quick. I mean, it's not like we need them for work, but better safe than sorry. Alright, send out some more. Okay, we got, Deep Hollow. Son of a... I don't know if I'm gonna be able to rescue all the survivors. No. Okay, we'll send out that scouting party. And... maybe see if I can't research more. Because if I can form another scouting party and send them out, I should be able to. Hopefully. I don't know, that's cutting it close. Okay. Alright. Don't think I need any more heating stuff. I mean, I'm good on coal mining. My automaton need redesign. I can't afford that, even if I wanted it. Where is it? Explosion industry? Here we go. I'll boost the number of parties that we have out there. Oh, shit. Emergency shift. I'll turn on the heater. Our discontent is so freaking high. We're gonna be able to drop it a good amount, though. Here's just a split second with the temple. Faithful sailors! Come on, get off cooldown. There we go. Boom, boom. Boom. Okay, I'm sorry, but I need to throw out another one. People hate me. Apathy sets in. Working very slowly. After so many hours of toil, they've become apathetic. They don't see how we can survive the storm. Lower efficiency or ask the phase keepers. screw it, whatever. We'll just have it work at 50% efficiency. Since we've also got the other one working full power. So at least that's something. Okay. Let's speed the... Oh, wait. Ah, here we go. No, one of them froze. Yep, we lost one of them. Well, at least we're hopefully gonna get two of them? Then that means that researching more scouts was a dumb idea. Abort. Dang it. Automaton integration? Yeah, that's the only thing I can really think of at the moment. Because, honestly, we need to be able to have our automatons pumping out coal like crazy. Let's see where we're at on resources per day. Because, let's see, we're doing pretty good on coal. Wood, I don't care. Steel, I don't care. Food, yeah, we're doing good on food as well. Do I stockpile more coal or food? That's the real question. I'll fight over supplies. Certain argument erupted between some workers last night. Some of them wanted a portion of the resources their facility produces so they can be... so they can prepare for the storm. It came to blows, and though nobody was seriously injured, tensions are running high. Yeah, keep me updated. We're starting to descend into anarchy, boys! Here we go. This one starts to get crazy. Resources. No, I need to build a resource depot. Or, no, I've already got one right here. Store extra food in that one, and then we'll build another one for coal. We need to store some more coal. Ah, right there. Just want to make sure that. Ooh, I'm sweating over here. I'm nervous. Temperature's gonna drop in a split second. Guys weren't able to join us last night, go ahead and go over to our Twitch and check out the Halo Infinite stream from last night. Yeah, yesterday they dropped co-op for Halo Infinite, so I need... Oh, no, it was the day before yesterday. That's right. Ended up hitting up a friend of mine immediately and was like, dude, yes, we have to. We have to, and it was fun. It was funny as hell. We found so many bugs, but... nothing like game breaking or like nothing too messed up. It was just funny stuff here and there. It was awesome. We had a lot of fun. So I would go check that out if you are you guys. You can also come join us later on tonight for some more Dead Space. Picking up where we left off from last time. Oh, mob storms the stockpiles. Really? Wait, what? Sir, a crowd of terrified people has stormed the stockpiles and started plundering our supplies. We managed to fight them off, but they demand wood for heating and to reinforce their homes. We'd need over 1,000 wood to supply everyone. What? I have 24 hours to get over 1,000 wood? How? Disperse the crowd, people might get hurt, the city comes first.
don't think there's any way I would be able to get over 1,000 wood in 24 hours. I could try. The only thing that I could honestly think of is building a ton of sawmills. But I'd have to also be able to store it. How the hell would I be able to do that? No. Disperse the crowd, I think. No, I'm gonna regret this. Sticking to it. I'm probably gonna hit myself.
Lock time, get moving.
Did nothing happen? I don't think anything happened. Also, this job shelter is pretty low in temperature. Okay, that boosted the health a bit. Oh, we need to build another house. House. Right there. We need to extend the street though. Almost done with it. Automated automaton integration. Sweet, we got more storage space for coal. There we go. What do we want to research next? Some air insulation. Heating, probably. Heater efficiency. That's tough. Heater efficiency? I guess that probably would be a good idea. I'll cut down on coal. At the same time, advanced heaters would be nice. That's tough. Maybe wait a minute. Yeah, healthcare insulation 2. I don't have to heat them up as much. Need more wood though. Now we have enough healthcare insulation, I guess. Let's also, can I throw more rations at him? I don't think I can. I think I already did for every one of them. Yeah. Oh well. Also, we pretty much maxed out our food. Like, we've got way more than we need, honestly. Would it be
be a smart idea to convert one of these food storage to coal. Maybe? That's a good question. Probably, honestly, because I don't need that much food. Yeah, now we've still got all that food. Awesome. That's actually kind of broken. We can bring back actual kills. Also, Book of Laws. Is there anything at last minute that we could use? Triage. That's a worst case scenario. If we just start having people die left and right, that's when it's like maybe triage is probably a good idea. What about under our purpose tree? Just denunciation. Huh. Occasionally event the lenders. We already dealt with the lenders. Small amounts of resources may be uncovered as well. This continues. I can think of it's like field kitchens, but we don't really need that. So there's no laws that we really need. I kind of figured, but also our outpost team. How do we disband these guys? Dismantle? I guess. Maybe. Or we do this. No. Dismantle it or something. It says 3 days. Huh? That's weird.
Finish your labels, people.
Okay, we're about to get more healthcare insulation. Boom. Better healthcare insulation. Sweet. I don't think I need cookhouse insulation. Heater efficiency, advanced heaters. Heater efficiency? Because I can't really get coal mines and stuff, like the highest tier. That requires too many, what are they called? Steam cores. No, I've got houses of healing instead. So I think probably the best thing to do is heal efficiency. Almost feels a storm! Also, I'm wondering if it would be worth it to build a steam hub right there. Also, these guys, they screwed up and weren't able to reach their objective. Wait. What? Inaccessible. Great! We failed to rescue two of the teams. One of the team's survivors. Yep, nabbit. Honestly, once the storm starts hitting here soon, I'm probably just gonna start shutting down a bunch of businesses that I don't really need. It still says that I failed on the outposts. Oh! Oh, I'm dumb.
the people that died earlier, the group, they were the outpost team from out there. Oh. So I didn't need to destroy that outpost. Whoops. Y'all need Jesus.
Yeah, me.
Stand that. Let's do that, and then it won't let us go any further over there. That, 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 whatever. And then. Just throw a gathering post right there if we can. Not valid. Balls. That's dumb. And let's dismantle part of this and fix that. Just do this, I guess. Looks kind of odd, but whatever. And yeah, we'll just. Yeah. Oh, here? Yeah, that's a hell of a lot better. Actually, it's a tough one. Still right there. Even though I don't plan on using it at the moment. Probably shut down that are heating. The only ones that I can think of are honestly the workshops. Get more sick people. But they're being healed pretty quickly, which is nice. We're still waiting on our church services. Give more rations to these guys so they can heal people quicker. And then we'll save some of the other ones. That's nice. We're full on steel?
What?
Oh, that's right. I've got two automatons on that. Throw one of them back on coal. Just stack up on coal. Yeah, that's dirty. We've got still a ton of food coming in, so that's good. And we've got all our stockpiles. Just massive, massive stockpiles. We are gonna build another resource depot.
Brace yourselves. Cold is coming.
That coal. I hear it. We got over 5,000 coal. That's disgusting. Yeah, let's build another steam hub. Oh, that's tough, actually. Wait, what? They're bunkhouses. Hold up. Oh, they're not actual houses? That house is super cold for some reason. How far out is this reaching? Okay, it looks like it's pretty much reaching all of them. Let's actually extend the range on that one. Thank you.
all these workshops are like super cold. It's too cold in there? Ah, oh, come on. That's booty. That's booty. Where's our outpost? Let's see. There's an outpost. Just bend that. Check. Advanced heaters? Alternative would be like cookhouse insulation. Nah, advanced heaters. Okay, we're burning through our food. Because we are not able to produce any at the moment. Gatekeepers. Make sure that they're heated. Okay, we're doing killer on the coal. We're suffering on food still. Shame we weren't able to rescue those survivors. Dang. Okay, that fixes all the bunkhouse problems. I can't believe I still had some. I guess I didn't realize it because they were literally hugging the generator. Haven't already, go ahead and go check out my Twitter and my YouTube. The links to that are through my Twitch. Or if you're watching this on YouTube later on, you can find the links to my Twitch and my Twitter through my YouTube. So go ahead and follow me on those. That would be much appreciated. You guys can tune in later on today as well on Twitch to see me stream some more Dead Space. We've been having a lot of fun with that. It's been really dope. That will be from 6 to 9 Pacific Daylight Time. You guys can find my streaming schedule up on my Twitch. Currently, it's looking like the streaming schedule is going to be 6 to 9 Pacific Daylight Time, Saturdays and Sundays. As well as the earlier morning one, like what we're doing right here on Sundays, where we're playing more like strategy games. Let's see, losing blood. Whenever people had to undergo an amputation, at working in the freezing cold left him with such severe frostbite with no other choice. Must be doing something. I already have prosthetics lost, so 2, 3, 4. We need those advanced heaters. There we go. That's a lot better. How much coal are we burning through now? We'll see that in probably 2 seconds. The actual figure. Let's see, explosion industry. I don't really need that. Let's see. I mean, species, we can upgrade those, but not much use at the moment. Calcium insulation? Yeah. That's honestly a smart one. Let's go for it at the moment. Yes, good, good, good. Build those processes. Yeah, once the storm hits is when we're going to start shutting down businesses, though. 1 second. I need to build more cookhouses. That will serve to help process a lot of this food. Where do I put it though? That's a real question. I mean, best place I can pick up is probably like around. Kinda doesn't leave me much room to work with, so. Whatever. Did I build another one right here? No, actually, slash that right there. And that one right there. Build the road. I want to make sure that everything still looks good. Building those cookhouses, but whatever. Let's build us resources. Resource depot. Oh. Right there. We'll source it from there. Can I hit up the temple? Nah, not yet. Almost. Cookhouse insulation is boosted. Honestly, there's not really much else that I need. Tech-wise, I think we've pretty much got just about all that I need for the rest of the game. Or at least this campaign. Yeah. I guess for the time being, on that. Let me just make sure. Resource depot upgrades. Can't really think of anything. Yeah, I should be alright. That'll be the resource depot upgrade. I don't know. Storm's gonna hit in the morning. Here we go. This is when it gets nuts. Congratulations. Oh, so make sure that we hit that. We got 7 people freezing. Too cold? I think we should be fine on how much food we got. Still sketching me out though, because I'm like, I don't know if it's enough or not. It's that that's messing me up. I'll just leave that ring out there. City's looking dope, honestly. Like, let's pause that for a split second. Also, I love how it freezes the snow too. Looks cool. Like, that just looks dope. Let's reorient it. The Nerd Cemetery is out here on the eastern edge. Yeah. See, we've got a residential area. We've got medical centers. Food. Industrial on the outer edges. Research wing. It's good. Here we go. The storm's gonna hit morning. Temperature's gonna drop a level. And I'm pretty sure it's gonna drop a level each day, if I remember right. Let's halt everything on these guys. Okay, let's take a look at where everyone is, real quick. Let's turn off the overlay. Okay, got a lot of people out here. First, let's take a look out here. Sawmill is already off. This cookhouse is going to have to be turned off. This house of healing, let's turn up the temperature, actually. Okay. This cookhouse is going to have to be turned off as well. Same with this one. This is just too damn cold. Let's see. This house of healing should be alright. Same with the other one. These are all hunter's hangers and stuff, and I'm pretty sure it doesn't really matter on them, honestly. Yeah, no, I think I do have to shut them off. Let's do that real quick. It's gonna take a split second. I built so many to stockpile so much food because I was so nervous about it. In the end, I have more food than I can. Than I have anything to do with. Like, shit. I have enough to feed a freaking small country. Let alone this city. If only there was a way to use like multiple humans at a time. That'd be nice. Looks like I shut all those down. Okay, that should be fine on that. What about engineers though? Okay, workshops are closed. That one's closed. Factory. It's getting closed as well. Let's see. Our other workshops. Yeah, they're gonna have to get closed as well. About our medical facilities, that's like the only thing left. Okay, we're good on them, I'm pretty sure. Looks like it. Our children are fine. Let's see, is there anything else? Anything else that I need? Let's see. All of our heaters are fine. Like, there's steam hubs. Want to boost the temperature, you can just crank up the generator. Let's do that. And let's see how hot that makes everything around here. Thank you. Oh, yeah, we're praying that we actually survive this, yeah. Upon the city, and the generator creaks and groans under the weight of the wind. Pale faces turn towards rattling windows, trembling lips utter words of prayer. The cold will be brutal. Hunting is impossible. The soil in the hothouses will freeze. We'll have to make do with the food we have stockpiled. The city must survive. Good thing we prayed and stuff beforehand. Temperature will drop 1 degree each day. Wait, hold up. Who's still working? Do the flying hunters just keep working? Also, will I be fine with these? Does range setting also up the heat level? That's the real question. Thank you. Yeah, let's actually do that real quick. Just have them go on a mad streak of healing people. Because we're going to get a ton of sick people. Objective. I just realized that. How did I not notice? Wow. It's literally just survive. Hopefully. Would there be any way for us to use these? Maybe if we... on the heater? I was thinking of maybe some research that we could get. I'm scared of people in our houses and stuff freezing. But we have all the upgrades that we can get for it. Like, we have like all the heating upgrades and shit. The only other one is like generator safety bypass. Which, I mean, that's almost worth it. Oh, okay, cool. The temperature is pretty nice in here. There. On. What about the other ones? Some of the other ones as well. You guys are going to be doing a quick shift. For heating. Generator safety bypass. Yes. Temple is mad. That has influence in people. Mad never gets. anything else. So we don't have enough steam cores for the advanced gold mine. Automatons are pretty much all maxed out with their efficiency. Heating is like all maxed out except for the range of our generator. Good. Put that down, you guys can go home. Wasn't really a 24-hour emergency shift, but you guys had to work a couple extra hours. Got some overtime. I just thought of, is there still money in this? Like, is money still really a thing? Or are they just living on universal basic income? Or are they just using trade? Or is it totally, like, the purest form of communism ever to where literally everyone gets a share? Just given the situation. I don't know. Sir, one of our engineers wants to talk to you. He's concerned about the danger that the cold poses to our mines. We're doing everything we can to heat the mines, but the air we're pumping into the shafts is so cold now that the hydraulic roof supports are starting to freeze. When they do, tunnels will start collapsing and keeping it warm. Oh, ha ha. That's scary. There's like nothing I can do about it. Resource depots. Do we have any that are storing raw food that we can just switch over to coal instead of having to actually build? Looks like most of our food rations. Just got so many things. Ah, here we go. Raw food, change, total. Maxed out on raw food. Like, over maxed out. Same thing with wood. Do we have any coal piles that an automaton might be able to, like, scavenge from? Doesn't look like it, though. Jesus, dude. Temperature's about to drop again. That's scary. For it to get this cold. I don't know either. Holy hell, 130 below. That's insane. Wow. Wait, is there any way without going into the settings? No, I gotta go into the settings to switch it. For the longest time, I was just using metric. It's roughly, I think it's like 18 degrees.
Ready yourselves, cold is coming.
Fahrenheit. For every, like, what, 10 Celsius, I think it drops. Alright, coal is still okay. People are chilly in their homes. freezing. Ah, no. Let's see. Sir, it's so cold that the hydraulic roof supports and our coal mines are failing. If the tunnels collapse, the lower levels will be cut off. We should either abandon them or send volunteers to replace the supports, but the task is extremely dangerous. Send volunteers. We need those coal mines. I'm sorry. 30 of our people died. How? Wait. Hope skyrocketed, though. Damn, they froze in our medical post. Huh? It's like some random cold spell just flew over them. Just killed them. What the hell? Still super, super cold. It's chilly. Low risk of falling ill. Let's see, cold is moderate. Very cold is high. Let's see, right now it's chilly, so it's gonna drop 1, 2, 3. Ah, it's gonna get all the way down to freezing. Oh no, oh no. Oh no. Will we survive though? I don't know. Can we even sit at that level for a while? Or would everyone die from sitting at that temperature for so long? Alright, I'm giving a lot more rations away. Ah, the faith keepers. Yes, send them out. Whatever, we might as well spend some resources. Trying to survive the actual cold. Because as long as our healthcare facilities, I think, are kept pretty warm and we keep pumping them full of extra rations. More hands needed. Sir, the volunteers we sent to keep the mines running weren't enough. There's been a cave in. Either we sent more people to open the tunnels or replace the rest of the supports, or the sacrifice of the first group will be in vain. Send more people. Fifteen of our people died. Fuck. Back on, because then we should use I don't think so. I mean, I know. It's question time. Alright, it looks like these houses are chilly. So I'm trying to build it. I'm just gonna start blanketing freaking city. Looks like all our memories and stuff are fine too. Oh, maybe we could build more of that real quick. Let's build another care house. My compliance operation. Sir, the volunteers managed to replace the critical supports in the upper level of the compliance. The critical supply is safe for now, but the cost was great. 45 more people paid. A chance to survive. Really honored, yes. Oh my gosh, yeah. With that, we can only survive like a couple of days without. Oh my gosh, I'm just barely squeaking by. I'm like barely squeaking by. Temperature's still gonna drop to what? 3 levels? Oh my, how the hell are we gonna survive? Thank you.
sure what else. Like, what my other options are. Because it's super cold in people's houses, and it's about to get very cold. Calculations with the new data. The storm will pass in a couple of days, but the temperature just before the end will drop drastically. Nothing can protect us from such a cold. Panic is starting to spread. There are no children in the shelters anymore. So, let's go ahead and turn off the heaters. Actually have more in store. Let me save that. Again. Maybe. People refuse to got 20 million other fucking workers. Don't want to dip into the red on the floor. So my question of the day for you guys, what is your guys' favorite season? I personally like winter. The only thing I don't like about it is actually driving in it. I don't like when the roads are slick. That's the only thing I don't really particularly care about when it comes to winter. But I love the snow. I come from an area to where we get a good amount in the winter. It also gets stupid cold. So you kind of get used to it growing up. Thank you. also curious to see if, going back on earlier, when talking about games, various ones, wondering if you guys wouldn't mind seeing some heavily modded Minecraft. Because that would honestly be pretty fun. Maybe set up like an extra stream. I don't know. It seems like Frostpunk's doing good. But at the same time, I don't know. Because we could continue doing more Frostpunk and do the DLCs. I've got all the DLCs. I think a possible alternative would be on Sundays. Kind of doing what we're doing, but instead of doing a 3-hour stream of, say, Frostpunk, do a 2-hour stream of Frostpunk and do like another 2 hours of, say, Minecraft. So 4 hours. That'd be kind of fun. Also, being able to bust out electrical games. But we're gonna wait until right before the storm hits. Okay. We're also gonna take a look at where is our coal consumption coming from. It's coming from like all of our medical facilities. Like, wondering if when we turn on the overdrive, we can turn off a lot of heaters to maybe help compensate. Facekeepers, we can almost use those guys. Ah, looks like we we'll start healing this moment. We can get some extra cautions. water ran out onto the ice, and he's like, sir, I want you to, like, hook me up with a ton of food and some other supplies. And we're like, I don't know about it, man, because we're already, like, hurting really bad. Like, this was back when we were wondering if we'd actually get enough food to survive, and worrying about that already, like, dangerously low. And it's like, I don't know, man, you're gonna get food. Anyways, he's like, I trust you, man. Miracles happen. Sir, it's a miracle. The man who went looking for his daughter is back. He brought her with him. He says that he found her soon after leaving the city, but then got lost and had to wait for a lull in the blizzard to find their way back. They are both exhausted and frostbitten, but very happy. I am glad to hear that. That is dope. That is pretty dope. I was a little nervous for a minute. Whenever you see the event thing pop up, it's like, oh no. Is there anything else? Anything? No, that was prior to gathering. No other heating and stuff like that yet. Yeah, I'm messing all on that one. So, we're gonna shut those back off. Charcoal kilns and build those 70 wood to 210 coal. Not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. And since we're having an automaton do it, I mean, just throw it out here by our wall drill. every 20 minutes? Yeah. facilities are too cold. Except for, like, the House of Healing. Wait, that's it? That's it? I saw the sun icon, but I was confused. And I saw this, where it looked like it was frozen. I thought we had to survive 3 levels for a couple of days. What? No way. The storm ends. Wind dies down and the temperature finally starts to rise. An eerie silence descends over the city. Overdrive. Yo, look at the temperature. We did it. We did it. We did it. We lost so many people, but we did it. Oh, that was painful. That campaign. Oh, that was rough. We have survived. Oh, this is the part that I've been waiting for, is the time lapse. Oh, I love this part. We started as a small society. Some refugees. 80 people. No food. Old habits. First, we decided to tighten our belts. Then soup became our main meal. Bullshit! I only did that at the very end. And every day was a struggle. So we adapted. Just that explosion was so sad. That's the feeling. Evening prayers. Faith keepers maintain care. Where we got hit by the plague. Yet I think we haven't crossed the line. Yeah! Faith gave us strength. We survived. That felt so good. Finally completing the first campaign on Frostpunk. That felt good. That felt real good. Honestly, I got way more nervous than I needed to get the whole time. Because I played this before and I'd beaten it, like all the DLCs, but it's been just so long, but I remember how brutal the ending of this one was, and just in general, the endings of each one, but this one in particular. So, I was freaking out the whole time, thinking, oh, I need to stockpile on everything, like, just go overboard. It turned out better. Honestly, it's a shame that we lost so many people along the way, but that's part of this game, honestly. You guys are going into it thinking that you guys are going to be able to save literally everyone. Good luck. Good luck. No way that you guys are going to be able to. But, that being said, it is honestly a good challenge. If you guys want to have some extra fun with this game, try it. The no deaths challenge. Sadly, we failed on that one. But, like white, like those can be different depending on how things went. someone behind and how we still felt the moral high ground. It's like, yes. Books of New London will still say that we were a good people. We stuck together, which is how it should be. Just a little bit before I end off, if you guys haven't already, go ahead and follow the publisher's page for Frostpunk on Steam. You guys can get a free monument to the builders of the generator. This building is pretty dope. The sad thing is that you can only use it in endless mode, but it's still really cool, and you guys can see it looks fantastic. So definitely go give them a follow over there. And if you guys haven't already, go ahead and go follow me over on Twitter, as well as go check out my YouTube or Twitch, depending on which one you guys are on. The links to all those are in the descriptions of either. Let's see. Yeah, I'm thinking next time we could probably do the arcs. That one's honestly probably my favorite out of all of them. Out of all the different stories, I really like the arcs. It's got a really cool subplot. It plays differently. Like, they all play completely different to each other, but that one's just really fun. I like that one. So we can probably expect to see that next Sunday at the same time, at noon to 3 Pacific Daylight Time. I would start that at the moment, but I want to keep things all together and neat, separated by the campaigns. But, if you guys have missed any of the streams, you guys can go check those out on YouTube. I am periodically uploading those as well, shortly after they end up getting streamed, so you guys can go check those out. Been fun getting hyped for the remake that comes out January 27th. Oh, I'm so excited. But without further ado, I'm just going to